Hello everyone, welcome to Chapter 4, Learning About Mainstream Industry Development Frameworks. In this chapter, we will mainly introduce what deep learning frameworks are and the advantages of these frameworks. Then, we will introduce you to two mainstream industry deep learning frameworks, including PyTorch and TensorFlow. Next, we will explain some basic operations of TensorFlow in detail. The version of TensorFlow we're discussing here is TensorFlow 2. These basic operations include matrix operations and some common modules within TensorFlow. The most typical aspect we'll cover is how to use TensorFlow to define neural networks, including how to define convolutional layers and fully connected layers. Lastly, through a simple handwritten recognition experiment using EMNIST, we'll gain a deeper understanding of the whole modeling process of a neural network framework based on TensorFlow. Through this process, you'll also become more familiar with the basic operations of TensorFlow 2. This is the content we will be covering in this chapter. After completing this chapter, we'll understand what a deep learning framework is and be able to list the current mainstream deep learning frameworks. We'll know the characteristics of PyTorch and the characteristics of TensorFlow. TensorFlow is divided into version 1 and version 2. Compared to version 1, version 2 is much simpler to use. It has built-in mechanisms like vision and Finch. We will discuss in detail the differences between TensorFlow version 1 and version 2 in a moment. Then we will carefully explain the basic syntax and long-term memory modules of TensorFlow version 2. Finally, there's a small experiment involving EMNIST handwritten digits, and through this experiment, we'll walk through the entire deep learning modeling process. These are the insights you'll gain upon completing the whole course. Now, let's begin with the first lesson. The first session is an introduction to deep learning development frameworks. First, let's look at what a deep learning development framework is and what its advantages are. From the right side of the figure, we can see the logos of many deep learning frameworks, including the most commonly used TensorFlow by Google and PyTorch by Facebook. This also includes Cafe, Tiano, MXNet, and Huawei's deep learning framework called MindSwap. These deep learning frameworks primarily appear to lower the entry barrier into deep learning. We know that neural networks in deep learning consist of many neurons and have a very complex structure. The entire propagation method, backpropagation, and gradient descent process are all very complex. These frameworks essentially create the wheel for us, so we don't have to reinvent it. For example, commonly used functions like backpropagation, gradient descent, and some optimizations are already defined in these frameworks. We just need to call them directly. Also, the connection methods between neurons and each layer of the neural network can be directly implemented by calling functions. Generally, we don't need to define an optimizer or write an optimization method from scratch. The main purpose of deep learning frameworks is to lower the threshold for learning and programming deep learning. We can see the entire deep learning framework as a set of building blocks. Each component corresponds to a model, an algorithm, or a network layer in neural networks. With these frameworks, we don't have to reinvent the wheel, because these components allow us to freely combine and build the model we want according to certain rules. This explains the emergence and advantage of deep learning frameworks.